Hey, Sean Jantz here, and I am currently inside of a live, in the money, hourly binary trade here on Aussie dollar. So I'm long the blue line right there at 68.60. So you can see the trade. I bought it for $60, about 3 hours left. I have a TP order sitting there at 87. And so in the point of this video, actually, when I want to go into detail in, is I want to talk about making sure that you're giving yourself plenty of time for your trade bias to play out, right? And so if we go through, and I'll show you exactly what I mean by that. But if we kind of take you through my trade bias, let's go through the four-step trading process, right? So we start here on the bird's eye view, four-hour chart. We are what? We are severely overbought, right? We have now gone just below a negative two. We're actually almost at a negative, We're at about a negative 2.5, okay? And so we are severely overbought. But the good news about this is that starting about here, this is a very bullish market. So we're oversold in a very bullish market. You can clearly see how this market's very bullish, right? So price action on the bird's eye view is bullish and we're oversold. That's good, right? So we are buying in a very oversold market. Now, when we look to the left, okay, I wouldn't say that we are just, and when we look at structure, I wouldn't say we're just at a picture perfect level of demand. If I were to say, like, where's the demand pockets, it's kind of here and here and here. That's kind of where those demand pockets are sitting. Definitely, I'm not buying at just a picture perfect demand pocket, but the basis of this trade is how oversold we are on the content. And then the BTG were below, actually a negative 2.5, right? The market is just overextended itself. And so I'm looking for just a push back before the market closes. Now, the point of this is about giving yourself more time on sometimes. I want to give myself more time on this trade. So you notice I'm giving myself almost 3 hours. 3 hours to see if I can't get this to cycle higher, right? And so when we look at this, if we go to the 5-minute chart, the one of the reasons why I'm choosing to give myself more time is because the volume is crazy, crazy low right now. Volume was pretty steady about here early, late London session. But then starting about here, we're dead, right? Price is moving extremely slow. And so, but the good news is that you can clearly see, right? Lower lows, lower lows, lower lows, lower lows, lower lows. And now we're starting to what? We're starting to build that accumulation. We're starting to build sideways change control. We're starting to build some demand right here, right? So I know this is where I want to be long at right here. And you think about this, it's currently 12 o'clock Eastern. I'm giving myself to here, right? To see if I can't just get a little bit of a move up and then I'm going to take profits. And this is like if you've been trading really short term, 5-minute binaries, for an example, or even just, you know, 20 minute, like with binaries with 20 minutes left or 40 minutes left, right? Sometimes it's just you're not giving yourself enough time for your, and if you ever taken a trade, it loses, but then like an hour later and there goes your bias, right? And it's like, dude, sometimes when you notice market price action is really slow, the volume's light. So I want to give myself more time because I don't want to get caught in a really short-term binary. I'm going to take profits no matter what. I'm going to TP once we come back up into that little bit of resistance there at 68.71. So let's put 68.71, create alert. So no matter what, I'm going to TP right there. So for the next 3 hours, if I can get this to cycle right there to 68.71, or if I can get the theta just to go to 87, right? Just time decay on the binary. And so if I can get that to 87. So 2 hours, 52 minutes. Again, the point of this is that there's going to be moments when you see price action is a little slower, volume's a little slower. Give yourself more time on your bias to play out. And so this is a very, 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 very technical 4-step trading process trade. Step one, bird's eye view content, oversold. Step two, context. BTG negative 2.5. Step three, change control, right? And then step four, take profits. So I'm using the 4-step trading process and I'm just giving myself more time for the bullish bias. We're going to pause, we're going to come right back and we'll recap. Quick update here, TP order did just get filled. You can see the buy trigger, or the cycle at least, came in. It wasn't huge, but the cycle eventually came. I timed the entry to perfection because I waited for sideways change control. That was pretty simple. If you go here, you can see how the entry or the TP got filled there at 87. So pretty simple trade, lasted just about an hour and a half. And so you'll notice how I gave myself plenty of time to see if I could get these bulls to come. Sure enough, they did. I timed it to literally perfection. And a lot of this is, why am I starting to see a buy trigger here? Because of the four-step trading process. My bias is long. And so that's why that PDF will help you to develop these biases. And then just, you always want to make sure you're giving your trade enough time to let that bias come in, right? So hopefully you enjoyed this. You can go to btgcourses.com. And you can go to our BTG trading membership here. And so inside our membership, you're going to get access to a complete 45-plus video course, right? And it's going to teach you how to build that content. It's going to teach you how to build context, right? Implied standard deviation, structure. Then we're going to start putting it together using that four-step trading process. Here's that PDF. It's going to be a complete game changer. Then we're going to start teaching you how to time that entry on change control. Notice how I timed the entry to literally perfection. It's because I understood that we were building accumulation. I knew exactly where to enter because of change control, right? And then there's a lot of other good stuff going on here as well. Then you can get inside of our chat room, get the charts, get the trade plans, get a one-on-one training with Ryan Smith. There's so much here. We're here to help you. You can message Ryan here if you have any questions. He's online all day long. You can also do a free one-on-one introductory call with him as well.